Hi, this is Matteo from Connecting Software, and today I will be showcasing Document Extractor for Salesforce. In this video, you will see how to register for a trial, configure the solution, and a short demonstration of the solution in action. So let's get started, shall we? Anyone may register for a free trial by heading over to our website, hovering over the Products tab, and clicking on Document Extractor under Salesforce Document Management and Integration. This will take you to the solutions page where you can register for your trial. We will be trying out the SaaS version of the solution. Add the solution to your cart. You will be required to enter some of your details, then specifying whether you are based in the US or in the EU. Finally, place your order and wait for your email. In your email, you will find two items, your activation code and a button to complete your registration. Click on Complete Your Registration, and all that you will need to do is enter a password, as your details will already be populated. Directly after registration is complete, you will find yourself on the new configuration screen for Document Extractor. Now, before we create a configuration, it is important to know three things. Firstly, you will need to create a new user in Salesforce with a username that begins with Document period Extractor. It is extremely important that you set up this user as a system administrator in Salesforce. Secondly, after creating the new user, request the new security token for that account. We will need it shortly. Finally, it is advisable to test the solution in a sandbox first before deploying to any production environment. So we will be setting up for a sandbox in this guide. Good. So give the configuration a name, select the sandbox instance, then enter the details for the service user and paste the security token that you have just regenerated here. Click Test Connection and wait for the test to run. If you see this error message, don't worry. The connection was successful, but we are being informed that Document Extractor needs to be installed into Salesforce for it to fully succeed. So click the Install into Salesforce button and wait for it to install. Once it has been installed, try testing the connection again, and now it will be successful. Next, we will be configuring the connection to SharePoint. As you can see, there are many ways to log into SharePoint. If one method is not working for you, or if you simply prefer one method over another, the choice is all yours. Today, I will be using the basic username and password combo. Enter your SharePoint URL and input the login credentials for the SharePoint account. After entering the login credentials, the document library field will populate with potential places to save the extracted documents. Test the connection to see if it is functioning correctly. Good. Under Salesforce settings, we will tick Synchronize Deletion from Salesforce, along with Synchronize Renaming from Salesforce, and Stub Attachments as files. SharePoint settings are fine for now. And finally, under Server settings, we will enable Create Previews. Save your configuration and wait for it to verify. Once the configuration has been saved successfully, that means that the configuration has been correctly set up and is ready to be used. Before we start syncing, you will notice this banner asking for an activation code. We will need to click Activate Code Now, and we can then paste the key that we received in our email earlier. Once your license is active, the configuration is ready to start running. But before we run it, let's take a look at our Salesforce and SharePoint setups. So, in my Salesforce dashboard, I will be navigating over to Accounts and selecting Anyone. Here we can see that there are no notes or attachments. If we head over to SharePoint, we will see that it is empty. So let's head back to our Document Extractor configuration and start it up. Going back to Salesforce, we will add a new attachment for this account, and you will notice that nothing has changed. This is because, unlike other solutions that require loading an additional iframe window, our solution is directly built into Salesforce. This means that your Salesforce users will not need to change their processes because our solution works in the background without any intervention or without disturbing the user. If we now go back to SharePoint, we will see that shortly after uploading a document into Salesforce, a new folder is created. And in this folder, we are able to see not only the file that has been transferred, but also the account that it belongs to, all nice and organized. Say for instance, files need to be removed from that account, do it exactly as you would before. The process does not change. And once we go back to SharePoint, the file is gone. Bear in mind that this is all customizable to the user's preference. If for some reason your files are not transferring over to SharePoint, it is possible to view what the solution is doing by reading through the logs available on the Document Extractor dashboard. I hope you found this video helpful. As always, keep well. See you next time.